Today I'm going to be talking about assertiveness and why it is considered the healthiest communication style. Let's get started. What does it mean to be assertive? It means stating your honest feelings and thoughts in a concise, clear, and respectful manner. Assertiveness is simply one of many communication styles. Here are four common styles and the goals of each. Aggressiveness. The goal in aggressiveness is to win or dominate the other person. Passive. When someone is being passive, their goal is to avoid conflict at all costs. Passive aggressive. The goal here is to not only avoid conflict, but to get back at the other person by teaching him or her a lesson. Here's an example from a caregiver's perspective. Imagine you are on staff at a day program for intellectually disabled individuals. Your client William frequently gets into verbal altercations with his coworker Molly. You realize that Molly is intrusive and you understand his frustration, but William overreacts and ends up intimidating people around him. An aggressive intervention would look like this. William, you need to be quiet right now. I'm your staff person and you need to listen to me. If you don't stop, I'll see to it that you're kicked out of this program. When I use this aggressive communication style, William is simply overwhelmed by my authority. He has no opportunity to respond, explain, or discuss. He is simply being intimidated into changing his behavior. Next, let me illustrate the passive approach. William, our boss asked me to tell you to lower your voice. She'll get mad at me if you don't. So could you please just settle down a little bit? This approach offers no guidance to William regarding how he might develop new skills and interact in a different way with Molly. Next, let's look at the passive-aggressive approach. Okay, William, you need to just calm down. Everything's fine, okay? Then later, when William approaches me and wants to sign up for a special activity, I deny his request and I say, I think you know why I'm not going to let you do that, William. My response in that case is to try to teach William a lesson, but it only results in William feeling confused and angry. Finally, here's the assertive approach. William, I've noticed that you get frustrated with Molly sometimes, especially when she interrupts you. I understand why you might feel that way, but when you yell at her and use bad language, it ends up upsetting everybody around you. Would you be willing to sit down and talk with me about some different ways you could work with Molly? Notice that William is being treated with respect and is being spoken to in a straightforward manner. Remember that assertiveness is the healthiest communication style in any relationship. It's all about stating your feelings in a clear, respectful manner. You walk away from the interaction feeling calm and clean. There is no sense of, I got him or she'll be sorry now. So go practice your new assertiveness skills. Thanks so much for watching.